I have to remember to articulate properly. Yeah. Glad no one was watching that. Okay. So, here we are. Jumping back into my own private universe. I'm here with half a bottle of flavored water and some Stroot waffles. I'm just going to turn that my volume down. I'm hearing my echo is very unsettling, and I need to recenter my track IR because I am going to use it today, which is why the screen is zooming all over the place. So I'll try not to make you seasick. Oh yeah. It would also be an idea to remember I've really turned the system sound down so you can actually hear me over the special effects. So, where are we? The middle of nowhere is the short answer to that. But, you know, I bookmarked a few little A-class, A-type stars in this little nebula. And I'm some considerable distance away from the nearest starport. 11,000 light years. And we're not going to be doing all that tonight. But we're near a nebula, which is usually a good sign for seeing interesting space life forms. Let's have a look at these A-type stars, or class A. I'm going to have to be a little bit careful with the sound. I might crash into. So the system I'm after is behind me. But I'm hoping to find some space pumpkins. Yeah, you may see me check chat window in a while. Why the view is going to bounce around a little bit. Away we go. Honk the system. 28 bodies. Waterworld. Probably won't bother mapping them, especially since they're 90,000 light seconds away. Oh, and people have been here for me anyway. Not really point. metal rich bodies might have some space pumpkin. But clutter. Small. Silicate magma's not terribly exciting. Okay, so it doesn't really look like there are any biologicals in this system. Yeah. Okay. Right. Another one. Couple of jumps. You back up a little bit because a little discomfort. Hear the sound. Jumping into or a little bit through. Oh, there we go. I can hit Super Cruise again now. F-class star in the middle of a nebula. We might find something here. Yeah. Nebula are like magnet. For explorers, probably no surprise that everything in here has already been mapped. Could be an Earth-like. Yeah. 9,000 light seconds. Since it's not a first discovery, I am probably not going to go out all that way and map it. So, quite a nice little find. And there's a water world in here somewhere as well. Oh yeah. Ooh, two. Not at all. Okay, let's have a quick gander at the icy bodies. Doubt we're going to get any life on it. But you never know. I think we can probably take that as a no. Moving on then. If that's a water giant, to be in about the right place on the scanner. Bet it's already been tagged. Yeah. Very nice. They call these cappuccino worlds for obvious reasons. And no, I am definitely not going to spend a huge amount of time scanning it or mapping it. Keeping an eye out for lumpy potatoes for them. Kilometer radius. Quite small. Really want under 400 though. Oh, it was teasing me. Likely geological features, and then it changed its mind. Well, thank you very much. Waste my time like that. Highly likely. See about that. Not really. Be worth tapping the world to find the water geese as go SRV jumping. Probably not. A little smaller. Logical life forms are lovely and all that, but geological formations, I mean, I'm after life forms. Not like I'm gonna find any here, does it? Nope. Had enough of that. Right. Other class A that I wanted to check out before starting off my next waypoint. Grabbing my phone so I can keep an eye on the Twitters. Very spooky look to the popular scanner there. Okay. Never mind. Hello, the magnet. Yeah, I like Class Bs. They're probably my favorite type of star that you see in game. O's are, as you can probably tell from the color of my hood, we do like a bit of purple, but they're quite hard to find. Especially when you're wandering around. Right. So, question of the evening is, do I visit one of these two nebulae, or do I just plow on? Sagittarius. I think we'll pay it a visit. It's going to be a very long time until I come back out here again. Unknown permit. Really? Okay, well, I guess this place has been reserved for somewhere that they're going to want to keep for later in the story. Get rid of some of this clutter. I'm going to bookmark that. This area of space permit locked, or is it the route, like the direct route? Yeah. Probably a better idea to put a few more star types in. All right. Try and calculate the route. Let's see how close we can get. And at least we'll have a nice B-type star to look at. That's worth a level 2 scan, isn't it? Not been tagged. I'll take it. Polar ice cap. Huge. I think I'm going to need a Stroopwafel. Maybe I shouldn't eat these on camera, but no dignified way of doing it. A passable ring slalom course. Actually, it doesn't look that bad. Well, moving on. Nothing doing that. Either this place has already been scanned or predominant. Been here before. It's quite a nice looking. We got here. And he is such a pig in Super Cruise. Makes you wish you brought a crate phantom. Sorry, I thought I'd better finish chewing before I'm addressing that little comment in the chat. I didn't know that. Also found that spectral subclass matters too. Have to keep an eye out for that. What have we got here? Nothing worth stopping for. Can't quite remember how the subclass works. The higher the number, the hotter it is, or more massive it is. I have to look it up. Been a long time since I've studied stellar astrophysics. Yeah, that makes sense. The higher the number, the cooler it is, because astronomers like to do something things backwards. Like, the brighter stars have lower numbers in terms of their magnitude, and the more negative it is, the brighter it is. Well, thank you for that. Clarification. Oh yeah, on the system. Oh, I've got them all. mean, it is quite interesting that the Stellar Forge has put biological life in systems with like really hot young stars. Because you wouldn't necessarily expect them to hang around for long enough to allow life to actually arise. If your star's only going to be there for 100 million years before blowing up in a huge supernova, where are these space pumpkins and brain trees coming from? Right, how many jumps have we got? God, still 9. Isn't it always quite funny that every single star you fly by appears to be having a massive amount of magnetic field activity? Loads and loads of prominence. Without fail, pretty much. Not here. Look at that one. One with water baseline. Let's see what is on the satellite. Well, that'll be sod all then. That might be quite a nice world for SRV geezer jumping. Okay, that wasn't worth it at all, was it? Well, I suppose that was inevitable at some point, wasn't Paying attention. Let's try that again. Or just not like I'm running out anytime soon. Moving on. I haven't really flown the Beluga that much. Fortunately with this, I can shut down enough subsystems that I very rarely have to use the heat sink. Besides, I've got a field maintenance unit and hull limpets on board, so. Well, bodies in. Far away. Yeah, I didn't quite go for the two maintenance. I know you have one to repair the other. But the first time I went to Beagle Point was before engineering. Yeah, that was fun. In a 32 light year ASP. And no repairs. Tempting to map that ammonia. We'll leave it as a present for someone else. They can have the joy. Close to that nebula now. I'm really interested to see where the permit locking starts. Not stopping. Crashing on this. Four more. Pseudo waypoint. Now entering Riker's home. Edging just that little bit closer to civilization. One thing I need to do before I get this commander back to what's laughably called civilization is pay a visit to some void hearts. I've seen screenshots of them, but I've never actually visited them. Along with the radioactive gas giants. one of those personally as well. I've been playing this game for 6 years and there's still so much I haven't seen. That was everything. Yeah, I'll almost certainly have to use the codec. Find a lot of the things that I've not seen. But I think Void Hearts are top of the list. I also need to work on the Guardian grind. I've visited a couple of the surface outposts, but I've not seen one of the space stations. Ooh. That's not. That's. Probably the one thing I want to scan in the systems hiding behind this. Grand Stormcloud. If that's the one with the kind of like lightning strikes, I've not been in one of those either. Again, seen the videos. Well, yeah, someone else can map that, can't they? 357 light seconds. I'm not that desperate. Find this gas giant. See if it has a lumpy potato in orbit. Probably not. Cover. And, oh, that's quite small. Small enough. Yeah, I fly using a HOTAS. I don't have force feedback, unfortunately. So I used to play Free Space 2 with a Cytek Cyborg 3D force feedback. Yeah, that was good. That was pretty impressive. When you kick the afterburners in, the joystick will be jumping out. Very, very good. Fortunately, I'm so used to playing with a HOTAS now. I can't play those old things like TIE Fighter and Free Space 2. They don't really work with HOTAS terribly well. Right there on the lumpy potato. There's only four more things left. Smallest thing, 400. When the radius gets under 300. That's when the shapes get really. They are very rare. Be or not to be. Egg. Couple of teeth. Always looks so weird under blue light. Rocky body? Baron. Crikey. 25,650 atmospheres. Swim in that. Just one iron magma vent. Waiting on the scan for, wasn't it? Okay. Sign of life here. Not entirely, on it. Ah, there. Get to the point. Way up. Out here, then. So either we've just found Raxler, haven't found. This is where the INRA hang out. Okay. Boundary. This clear by terminal. Obviously, don't want going in. That sector. I can take. And really see a few. Holes? Oh, neutron star. Someone hacked that by. Awesome. pointing at oh middle of an app. Wow. There is almost certain gonna be. Gonna be worth a dream or floor it. Oh, no. Actually, where am I? That. Gone? He jumps at 45. What about another hour? Not likely. I'm going to make 45 jumps in an hour. Where's our destination? I still haven't quite decided yet whether it's a good thing or not when you honk the system and it goes, system scan complete. On the good side, don't have to hang around for very long. On the other side, you're not going to find anything terribly interesting. times like this you wish you brought something with a longer jump range. Oops. Only the second. Twice in 1.25 hours. About my youth. Completely fried in it. It'll be fine. Ooh. I know a certain Mr. Rebuy who's interested in that. That looks like a good ring slalom course. Unfortunately, it's about 11,000 light years from anywhere. Might as well have a look at the gas giant. Another class one. Right. Or ammonia baseline. Water. White value. Taken. Oh, system scan. I think that's its name. Yes. Let me finish fuel scooping. I'll double check on the galaxy map. That nebula there. One we can't get to. Having a yeah. However you pronounce it. Is there something really nice there? I haven't checked the codex. Tiny nebula containing a neutron. See if I can find it. Where did that Osnog? Scan everything. I think you just described about three quarters of my bookmarks on the galactic map. I can almost guarantee that after all this scanning, really not gonna be. Didn't take quite so long to do that feature. Sure, I can bother with. Terraformable. Not a terribly pleasant atmosphere. Okay. There we go. Next. I wasn't. Find any lumpy potatoes. Oh, that's almost one. Little irregular. All but no signal. Life. Not quite small. Getting there. If not lumpy, it's definitely rumpled. Right there. Ooh. Nice ring slalom course. That for our good friend Rebuy. Off. They're all quite nice. Right. I can get another 10 jumps. So done. I don't mean get to that. Too much effort tomorrow. One of these days, I'm going to have to do a spreadsheet or something, see if there's any link between the type of gas giant and the size of its moon. That's definitely lump. Certainly irregular. Unless it's under 400. Kilometers in radius, I am not happy. Only a baseline. That's nice. At last. Yeah. been so long since I've had this commander at a starport that I have absolutely no idea how much money the data I've got on board. Probably going to double my balance. Oh, that's cheating. There he is. Yeah. I'm only jealous because I can't afford one. Can I honk this? Probably. Water worlds are always welcome. One's not terrible. Unless you're a Thargoid.